What does vaccination look like? Vaccination looks like babies smiling up at their parents. Vaccination looks like children in classrooms and adults going to work healthy and confident. Vaccination looks like a bustling market and a bus full of people heading to different destinations. Vaccination looks like growing old and looking back on a life well lived. Vaccination makes life possible. At the International Vaccine Institute, we believe everyone should lead a full and productive life. Infectious diseases affect every country in the world, but not everyone in the world is equally protected against them. That's where IVI bridges the gap. As a non-profit international organization with headquarters in the Republic of Korea, a regional office in Sweden, and collaborating centers in Ethiopia, Ghana, and Madagascar, IVI develops new and improved vaccines, making them accessible to the people who need them most. We are there at every step, from vaccine discovery in the lab, to vaccine delivery in communities, and every step in between, epidemiology to identify major global pathogens, lab research to create new vaccines for high burden diseases, phase 1-3 clinical trials to help develop vaccines and gain approvals, impact studies to show economic and social benefits of vaccines, advocacy and training to build capacity everywhere we work, and helping governments vaccinate their populations to reduce human suffering from preventable infectious diseases. We work with governments, companies, foundations, universities, hospitals, and other non-profit organizations to take innovative vaccine technology from need to impact. Our commitment to prioritizing poverty-associated infectious diseases led to the world's first affordable oral cholera vaccine and a new generation typhoid conjugate vaccine. Our priority disease areas also include chikungunya, shigella, salmonella, cystosomiasis, group A strep, hepatitis E, HPV, and COVID-19, in addition to global health issues such as antimicrobial resistance. We believe a world free of vaccine-preventable infectious diseases is possible. Join us in building a healthier, safer, and more equitable world.
Your Excellencies, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, good morning and welcome to the 2023 IVI SK Bioscience Park Man-Hoon Award Ceremony hosted by the International Vaccine Institute. Please allow me to introduce myself. My name is Ho Mi-so-dang and it's an absolute honor and delight to be serving as your MC for this very special occasion. 인사드리겠습니다. 저는 오늘 행사의 진행을 맡은 치과의사 서미소랑입니다. 반갑습니다. Thank you very much. The IVI SK Bioscience Award was established back in 2021 by the International Vaccine Institute in collaboration with SK Bioscience to honor and commemorate the legacy of their late Vice Chairman, Dr. Park Man-Hoon. Now, the 2023 award this year honors four individuals for their extraordinary contributions to the discovery, development, and delivery of vaccines worldwide and the consequent advancement of global health. We will open with a video in honor of the late SK Bioscience Vice Chairman, Dr. Park Man-Hoon. Please take a look.
Some say love. 우리의 시작이 된 사람이 있습니다. 끝이 보이지 않는 머나먼 여정의 선두에서 명확한 목표와 나아갈 방향을 제시한 사람. 무모한 도전이 아닌 실현 가능한 그림을 그려내는 통찰력. 구성원뿐만 아니라 파트너들조차 당신의 목소리에 귀를 기울일 수밖에 없게 만들었던 설득력. 그 모든 것들을 가능케 했던 당신의 섬세함은 오늘날 SK 바이오사이언스가 성장하는 원동력이 되었습니다. It's the heart. 어떤 이에겐 기댈 수 있는 언덕이었으며 또 어떤 이에겐 끝을 알 수 없는 태산과도 같았던 당신. 세포 배양 기술을 바탕으로 안전한 백신의 개발과 백신의 국산화를 이뤄 국내 백신 주권 확립에 앞장섰던 당신의 어른. 앞으로 SK 바이오사이언스의 새로운 100년에도 남아 함께할 것입니다. 지금의 우리에 대한 평판은 당신이 존중하고 지켜내려 했던 가치에서 비롯되었으며 그 가치들은 다시 우리의 명상이 되었습니다. 오늘의 우리는 당신의 노력 그 자체이며 내일의 우리 또한 당신과 함께함을 잊지 않겠습니다. 이제 우리는 당신의 이야기를 기억하며 앞으로의 내일을 만들어 가겠습니다.
Next, we have the pre-recorded opening remarks by Mr. George Bickerstaff, the chairperson of the IVI Board of Trustees.
Drs. Rina Rapoli and Margarisa Pisa, Professors Andrew Pollard and Sarah Gilbert, Professor Yu Hong Lim, President of Seoul National University, SK Bioscience CEO, Mr. An Yong, Excellencies, Distinguished Guests, on behalf of the Board of Trustees of the International Vaccine Institute, I am privileged to welcome you to the 2023 IVI SK Biosense Park Manyon Award Ceremony. I extend my sincere congratulations to the awardees, Drs. Rino Rapoli, Margarisa Pisa, Professors Andrew Pollard, and Sarah Gilbert. You have pioneered innovation in vaccine science and industry and championed global immunization. You have made phenomenal contributions to global health through the discovery of reverse vaccinology and the development of meningococcus B vaccine, Oxford AZ COVID-19 vaccine, which have saved numerous lives. The IVI SK Bioscience Park Manoon Award builds on a decade-long partnership between IVI and SK Bioscience. Together, these two partners have brought to market two vaccines, vaccine against typhoid fever and COVID-19. This robust partnership was made possible thanks to the leadership of the late Vice Chairman, Dr. Park of SK Bioscience, a visionary and vaccine pioneer who is credited for leading the development of novel vaccines for global health. In honor of his legacy, IVI and SK Biosciences jointly launched the Park Manoon Award in 2021 to promote vaccine innovation and help build a stronger global vaccine industry. I'd like to take this opportunity to thank SK Bioscience for your leadership and commitment to vaccines for global health and lasting friendship with IVI. I wish to thank the 12 members of the Award Selection Committee for your service in selecting the awardees among so many distinguished vaccine leaders. I also wish to thank all of you who have joined us today in celebrating the 2023 Park Manoon Award, and hope you find the ceremony and subsequent forum memorable, informative, and useful. With my deepest congratulations to the awardees once more, I declare the opening of the 2023 IVI SK Bioscience Park Manoon Award Ceremony. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Mr. Bickerstaff, for that warm welcome. Next, we have the welcome address, which will be delivered by Dr. Jerome Kim, Director General of IVI. Please welcome him with a big hand.
Thank you. Welcome, 안녕하십니까. Drs. Rino Rapuoli and Maria Grazia Pisa, Professor Dame Sarah Gilbert, and although he isn't here, Professor Sir Andrew Pollard. Professor Yu Hong Lim, President of Seoul National University, Your Excellency Federico Fala, Faila, Ambassador of Italy to the Republic of Korea, Mr. Gareth Weir, Deputy Head of Mission of the UK to Korea, SK Bioscience CEO, Jaeyoung An, Professor Sangchul Park, President of the Korea Support Committee for IVI, and distinguished guests. On behalf of the International Vaccine Institute, I extend my warm welcome to all of you. Thank you for coming to join us, in person or virtually, at the 2023 IVI Manhoon Park Award Ceremony. As Director General of IVI, it's my great privilege to honor the recipients of the second Park Manhoon Award, Dr. Rino Rapuoli and Dr. Maria Grazia Pizza, and Professor Dame Sarah Gilbert and Professor Sir Andrew Pollard. Dr. Rapuoli and Dr. Pizza jointly pioneered a new scientific approach to vaccine development. Reverse vaccinology takes what we understand about viral and bacterial pathogens and immune responses against them to design optimal vaccine candidates. Using this approach, they developed a highly effective vaccine against the type B meningococcus, a devastating infection of the central nervous system that occurs primarily in infants, children, and adolescents. Dr. Rapuoli was also formerly the chief scientist at GSK Vaccines and is now the scientific director of the Biotecnopolo di Siena Foundation in Italy. His immense contributions to vaccinology also include a molecule known as CRM197 that today is the most widely used carrier for vaccines against Haemophilus influenzae, Neisseria meningitis, and the pneumococcus, and is used to vaccinate most children worldwide. Dr. Pizza is the former Senior Scientific Director for Bacterial Vaccines at GSK and currently is a visiting professor at Imperial College in London. In the 1980s, she took on a research project that identified a genetically detoxified pertussis toxin as the ideal antigen for a novel vaccine devoid of toxicity but highly immunogenic. Afterwards, she conducted a trial that led to the identification of the new meningococcus B antigens using the reverse vaccinology approach. This allowed the development of the MenB vaccine, which has been licensed in more than 40 countries around the world. Professor Sarah Gilbert, Professor of Vaccinology and Pandemics at the Pandemic Sciences Institute of the University of Oxford, led the creation of a novel adenoviral vector COVID-19 vaccine made by AstraZeneca and also by SK Bioscience here in Korea. As one of the most widely administered vaccines in the fight against the pandemic, more than 3 billion doses of this vaccine have been released to supply over 180 countries, including over 580 million doses that were made available to COVAX, the international effort to distribute vaccines all over the world, but particularly to low and middle income countries. Professor Andrew Pollard, director of the Oxford Vaccine Group in the Department of Pediatrics at the University of Oxford, led the clinical development of the Oxford AstraZeneca COVID-19 vaccine. He's also conducted extensive clinical, basic, and epidemiological research crucial to the understanding of the burden of vaccine-preventable diseases. He's also led pioneering work on meningococcal, pneumococcal, and typhoid and COVID-19 vaccines, which underpin global policy on immunization against these diseases. Today, we are honoring these vaccine pioneers and innovators on the second anniversary of the late Vice Chairman Dr. Park Manhoon's unfortunate death. Thanks to his vision and leadership, IVI and SK Bioscience have been successfully collaborating in the development of a new typhoid conjugate vaccine and the COVID-19 vaccine. Both vaccines were licensed by Korea last year, which demonstrates the power of this partnership and the potential of science and innovation to do vaccine research for public good. As the world's only international organization devoted to vaccines for global health, IVI is committed to our partnerships with SK Bioscience and other collaborators worldwide to accelerate the development, manufacture, and use of vaccines, which greatly reduce the burden of neglected infectious diseases, including typhoid, cholera, schistosomiasis, and others. Building upon the legacy of the late Dr. Park, we will also continue to identify and acknowledge global vaccine pioneers and innovators like today's awardees who enable people everywhere to lead healthier and more productive lives free of suffering from infectious diseases. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Dr. Jerome Kim. We are now pleased to invite Mr. An Jae-yong, CEO of SK Bioscience, for his welcome remarks. SK Bioscience is a leading vaccine company based here in Korea and a long-term partner of the International Vaccine Institute.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Jae-yong An, CEO of SK Bioscience. First of all, I'd like to extend a warm welcome to all of our distinguished guests who have taken their precious time to attend this event, as well as the honorable recipients of the second Park Man-hoon Award. The Park Man-hoon Award started in 2022 through collaboration between IVI and SK Bioscience. It aims to pass down the passion for vaccine of the late SK Bioscience Vice Chairman Park Man-hoon, who passed away in 2021. Dr. Park was a great scientist who made significant contribution to vaccine research, especially as a leader of cell culture technology. Today marks exactly 2 years since his passing. It was a great honor for SK Bioscience to have been able to work with him. We believe that it is the responsibility of those who follow his footsteps to pass on Dr. Park's passion for vaccine research to future generations. The awardees have achieved remarkable accomplishments, like Dr. Jerome Kim mentioned, in the field of vaccines and continue to dedicate themselves in promoting global public health. I would like to take this opportunity to congratulate the awardees and ask for your continuous contribution to the field of vaccine in the spirit of Dr. Park's mission. Finally, I'd like to express my sincere gratitude to everyone at IVI for working tirelessly to make the Park Man-hoon Award a truly honorable and prestigious recognition in the field of vaccine research. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Mr. An Jae-yong, for that warm welcome. We would also like to have Professor Yoo Hong Lim, president of the Seoul National University, at the podium for his congratulatory remarks.
Good morning and welcome you all to IVI on the main campus of Seoul National University, especially Drs. Reno Rapoli and Maria Grazia Pizza, Professors Sarah Gilbert and Andrew Pollard, Dr. Jerome Kim, Director General of IVI, Jae-yong An, CEO of SK Bioscience, Professor Park Sang-chul Park, I'm sorry, President of the Korea Support Committee for IVI, Excellencies, and distinguished guests. On behalf of Seoul National University and the broader academia, it is my great pleasure and honor to attend the 2023 IVI SK Bioscience Park Man-hoon Award Ceremony. It is such a privilege to meet honorable awardees today and recognize your extraordinary contributions to developing vaccines and improving global health. My academic background is political science, but through IVI, I have gained some understanding about the power of vaccines, your important achievements in vaccine science and their enormous impact on global health. You are the heroes in humanity's winning fight against infectious diseases, and you are truly deserved this recognition for your tireless, successful efforts to discover, develop, and deliver life-saving vaccines. The COVID-19 pandemic has shown vaccine inequality between high and low and middle income countries poses a major threat to all humanity. The pandemic has taught us that the world should unite as one to overcome pandemics and be better prepared for avert health crisis. Vaccine is a pivotal part of the world's collective preparedness for infectious diseases, threat, and future pandemics. As an international organization devoted to vaccines, IVI is playing an important role in accelerating vaccines and addressing global vaccine inequity. In collaboration with numerous supporters and partners around the world, including SNU. SNU is proud to host IVI on our campus ever since its inception, and we remain committed to supporting IVI's mission to realize humanity's shared vision of a world free of suffering from infectious diseases through vaccines. In this light, I am delighted to join IVI and its partners today in acknowledging and honoring these vaccine pioneers, the second recipients of the IVI SK Bioscience Ban Ma-Hoon Award. With a shared vision with IVI, you have helped save countless lives and improved the health of the world's people. Once again, congratulations to you all, and I look forward to seeing your continued strides in the future ahead. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Professor Yu-Hung Lim, for that warm remarks. I think the sentiment of gratitude to our awardees has been echoed numerous times throughout the remarks. And the sentiment of gratitude for advancing and protecting mankind. Once again, thank you very much. So we will now proceed with the actual recognition. Now for the award, His Excellency Federico Faila, the Italian ambassador to Korea, will take the podium to introduce our two awardees from Italy, Drs. Rino Rapuoli and Maria Grazia Pizza. Thank you very much.
Director General Kim, President of SNU, CEO of SK Bioscience, professors, distinguished guests. First of all, I want to say I'm really, truly honored to be here today, to have been invited to this prestigious institute. The importance of the work of IVI is under the eyes of everybody. And in time where global challenges are by the day the most pressing issues we have to deal with in order to give a decent future to this planet. The recent COVID-19 pandemic has been a stark reminder of the risk mankind is exposed to, but we cannot forget the other endemic diseases that plague large areas of our planet. Just let me remind here that the Italian government is really committed to contribute to these efforts and is one of the major contributors to Gavi, the Vaccine Alliance, an example, a very good example of a public-private partnership with the goal of saving lives and protecting people's health. Global challenges require indeed global answers. Again, I want to thank IVI for actively promoting international cooperation in such a crucial sector. As a result of such international activities, today events recognize the contribution of two eminent Italian scientists in the field of vaccines. Dr. Rino Rapuoli is, as been said already, chief scientist and head of external R&D at GSK Vaccines. And he introduced several novel scientific concepts like genetic detoxification, cellular microbiology, reverse vaccinology, and pangenome. Well, the list of the things he achieved is very long. I will not go on also because it's not my field, really. So the more I say, the more I will make mistakes. So I will stop here saying that to be honored by this award, his achievements are very meaningful, very significant. And also this is can be seen because he has served as a visiting scientist at Rockefeller University in New York, Harvard Medical School in Boston, and again here the list of the things, the places where Dr. Rupoli has been, is been part is very long. And the second awardee is Dr. Maria Grazia Pizza, also working at GSK. She studied, as been said, the sequence and expression, the gene encoding for the human 1 glycoprotein. Well, I think her research has been fundamental for finding the ideal antigen for new vaccines. So she has achieved also many other results, she's been a member of EMBO, AM, and EAM. So I think also this is the proof of the importance of her work, of her achievements. So I'm very honored today to be the one to introduce the two. These two eminent scientists, and the fact that they are giving this award is very meaningful, and also the it's a tribute to the importance of international cooperation. This is the point. Science has no borders. Science requires collective efforts in a moment in which, well, the international community is not expressing its best in international cooperation. We have to remind ourselves that for the crucial aspect of that we are facing in terms of climate change, pandemics, endemic diseases, well, we should do really an extra effort to overcome some differences and try to find some common grounds. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Ambassador. Now we'd like to invite the awardees, Drs. Rino Rapoli and Maria Grazia Pizza, to the stage to receive the award. Professor Yu-Hung Lim and Dr. Jerome Kim, please also come forward to present the plaque of award and flowers. All right. The plaque reads, the IVI SK Bioscience Park Man-Hoon Award, presented to Rino Rapuoli and Maria Grazia Pizza for their extraordinary contributions to the delivery and development of vaccines for global health. April 25th, 2023. Everyone, please join me in giving Drs. Rapuoli and Pizza a big round of applause. Please deliver the plaque and flowers. Mr. An Jae-yong and Ambassador Federico Fela, could we invite you back up to the stage for a group photo, please? Right, everyone, please look at the cameras straight ahead of you. Please, let's bundle up a little bit together. Once again, please give a big round of applause to Drs. Rino Rapoli and Dr. Maria Grazia Pizza. Thank you very much, Drs. Rapoli and Dr. Pizza. Please remain on the stage. Everyone, please return to your seats. Dr. Rapoli, We will take the plug and flowers for just a second. If you can deliver the acceptance speech, please. Dr. Rapoli, please come to the podium.
Well, I'm deeply impressed and honored to be to receive this award today. I think the vaccinology is one of perhaps the most important part of civilization that mankind ever developed. Thanks to vaccines, today most of the countries people live longer because a lot of the infectious diseases which used to kill a lot of people have been eliminated. And so we have seen recently with the COVID pandemic that vaccines basically have been able to save more than 20 million lives. And if we had had more vaccines to deliver immediately worldwide, we're going to probably save another 20 million. So I believe the vaccines are the essence of modern society, where we live longer, we can be more healthy. And therefore, I think it's so important that vaccines are recognized. And I mean, vaccines have been my passion for my entire life. I spent more than 40 years doing that. And I'm very thankful to IVI and SK Bioscience for setting up this award. I mean, recognizing the things which are important for society is so important. We need to make sure that the values, the real values of life are recognized. So I really would like to thank you all for this award and for basically giving us the opportunity to be here. I'm deeply honored and humble, but it's all together, I think we are doing something which is fantastic. So I really thank you all for this.
Thank you very much, Dr. Rapoli, for that inspiring speech. Next, I would like to invite Dr. Maria Grazia Pizza. Please deliver your acceptance speech.
So thank you. Thank you really for this opportunity, for the recognition of the work that we have done. But also, I have to say, for the opportunity to come to Korea, to Seoul, and to visit the IVI and the SK Bioscience. So it has been really a tremendous opportunity, because I have really seen the passion, the motivation, and I am sure that you are going to do wonderful things in Korea. And so for the award per se, I have to say that, as Rino said, I can only echo. I've been working on reverse vaccinology for 20 years. And I have to say that today I am really proud, also because the vaccine is a reality. So this dream came true, and I want really to thank you once again for this recognition. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Dr. Rapoli and Dr. Pizza. You may return to your seats. I think your words of encouragement, Dr. Pizza, mean so much more coming from such an esteemed leader in the field like yourself. So thank you very much. Now, Mr. Gareth Weir, Deputy Head of Mission to the UK, of the UK to the Republic of Korea, will introduce Professors Sarah Gilbert and Andrew Pollard, who are from the UK. Now, unfortunately, Professor Pollard could not join us today in person due to conflicting schedules, but the award will be mailed to Professor Pollard. Please welcome Mr. Gareth Weir.
안녕하세요. A very good morning to you all. So, SK Bioscience CEO Dr. An Jae-yong, Seoul National University President Dr. Ri Hong Lim, IVI Director Dr. Jerome Kim, the extraordinary award recipients, Ambassador Fila, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen. It is a very distinct and rare honour to be here with you today to share in the recognition of the careers and remarkable contributions to global health security marked by the four 2023 International Vaccine Institute SK Bioscience Manhoon Award recipients. It's a privilege to be here on behalf of British MC Seoul and the UK government to introduce two of the recipients. The only downside is I only have a few minutes to try and summarise what are extraordinary lives of two very special people. I'm here, of course, to introduce the awardees, Professor Dame Sarah Gilbert, and on screen, Professor Sir Andrew Pollard. And while considering what to say, I was once again struck by the value and power of lives dedicated to public service, and how large a humanitarian impact people like Sarah and Andrew have had, not just in response to COVID-19, and how difficult it is to measure such an impact. We are increasingly in the age where scientists are not household names unless they are TV presenters. But in the UK, it is fair to say that what Sarah and Andrew have accomplished is not just well known to the British public, but it is of global renown within the scientific community. Professor Dame Sarah Gilbert is a specialist in the development of influenza vaccines and vaccines in response to emerging viral pathogens as a Said Professor of Vaccinology at the University of Oxford and co-founder of the biotech firm Vacitech. After an undergraduate degree in biological sciences at the University of East Anglia, Sarah received a doctorate in 1986 from the University of Hull, where her studies focused on the genetics of biology and yeast. Sarah started her postdoctoral research career at the Brewing Industry Research Foundation. Now, this is something that sounds a fantastic job to me. Time at Delta, a UK drug manufacturer, I'm sure then played an important part of her career. In the mid-90s, she moved to the University of Oxford to join the team of Professor Sir Adrian Hill, now director of the Jenner Institute, and himself a giant in the field of malaria vaccine research. With funding from the Wellcome Trust, Sarah began work on the development of novel influenza vaccines and was part of the team that developed the universal influenza vaccine that went into clinical trials in 2011. In addition to influenza, Sarah's worked on vaccines for MERS, Nipah, and potential vaccine for the Rift Valley fever. Sarah was made professor of the Jenner Institute in 2010. In 2016, she co-founded Vacitech with Adrian Hill, a spill-out from the University of Oxford, with a focus on the development of vaccines for cancer and infectious diseases. In early 2020, just a few days of emerging reports from China, Sarah began work on what would become the vaccine for SARS-CoV-2 or COVID-19. Sarah received the Rosalind Franklin Medal from Humanist UK, the Gold Medal from the Royal Society of Medicine, and the King Faisal Prize in Medicine. Sarah was made a Dame of the British Empire in 2021 for her services to public health. And I'm absolutely sure, and I've double-checked this, that Sarah will be the only person that has both received a standing ovation at Wimbledon Tennis Open and someone who has lent her image to the Barbie doll collection as an inspiration to new generation of scientists. Secondly, Professor Sir Andrew Pollard, who sadly cannot be with us today, is the Ashall Professor of Infection and Immunity and Director of the Oxford Vaccine Group. Andrew received his undergraduate degree from the University of London. He received his doctorate also from the University of London in 1999, studying immunity to meningitis in children. Andrew served as a clinician in paediatrics and paediatric infectious diseases in hospitals in Birmingham, London in the UK, and Vancouver in Canada. He moved to the University of Oxford in 2001, where his research since has focused on the design and clinical evaluation of vaccines for typhoid, meningitis, Ebola, and other infectious diseases, and of course, COVID-19. Andrew's support for the global health security efforts is very highly regarded. His research was the basis for the World Health Organization's pre-qualification of a new typhoid vaccine and recommendations for its use in countries hardest hit. Andrew served as a member of the WHO's Strategic Advisory Group, experts between 2016 and 2022, and was the chair of the European Medicines Agency's Scientific Advisory Group on vaccines between 2012 and 2020. He currently chairs the UK Department of Health and Social Care's Joint Commission on Vaccination and Immunisation. As the COVID-19 vaccine candidate emerged at the University of Oxford, Andrew was the chief investigator for the clinical trials of a vaccine that would eventually be manufactured around the world, including, as we've heard, here in the Republic of Korea. Over 3 billion doses have been distributed. He has received the Order of Medical Merit from the Federal Republic of Brazil, has been elected to the UK's Academy of Medical Sciences, received the 2019 Rosin von Rostein Medal for the Swedish Society of Medicine. He was also made a Knight of the British Empire in 2021 for his services to public health. Outside work, he's also an accomplished mountaineer and a member of the British Mountaineering Council. He was a member of the first British teams to successfully summit Jalali and Chamlang in the Himalayas, and the co-lead on a 75-person summit of Mount Everest. Both Sarah and Andrew's work in rapid response to the outbreak of COVID-19 and the development and testing of what has become known as the Oxford vaccine and subsequently the AstraZeneca vaccine has quite literally saved millions of lives. It can be argued that their work, in cooperation with colleagues at the University of Oxford, has revolutionized the vaccine development process, showing that a process previously taking years from candidate through trials to deployment can be radically and safely shortened to less than a year in response to the most dangerous emerging infectious diseases. Their contribution to global health cannot be understated. They have shone a spotlight on the fine tradition of UK research capability and represent the absolute very best of British and global science expertise. It is therefore with a huge pleasure that I'm here today to make this brief introduction, to offer my thanks to the International Vaccine Institute for the invitation and for the award ceremony today. And of course, it's a huge privilege to offer the warmest congratulations to Professors Dame Sarah Gilbert and Sir Andrew Pollard on receiving this very well-deserved award. Kamsahamnida.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much, Mr. Gareth Weir, for painting a multidimensional picture of our distinguished award recipients. Now we would like to invite Professor Dame Sarah Gilbert to the stage for the award. Professor Yoo Hong Lim and Dr. Jerome Kim, once again, please come to the podium. We will hand over the plaque and the flowers. Once again, the IVI SK Bioscience Park Man-hoon Award presented to Professor Dame Sarah Gilbert for her extraordinary contributions to the development and delivery of vaccines for global health, April 25th, 2023. Everyone, please join me in giving Professor Dame Sarah Gilbert a big round of applause. Mr. An Jae-yong and Mr. Gareth Weir, please come forward to the stage for the group photograph. All right, before we move, Drs. Rapuoli and Dr. Pizza, Ambassador Federico Fila, please come to the stage once again and we will take a big group photograph. We will redistribute the plaques and the flowers once again, the bouquets. Okay, extra big smiles. Please look at the cameras ahead. Thank you very much. Now, before we let you go, the three awardees, please remain on the stage and we'll take some more photographs. Just because it's an extra special occasion. Everyone, please congratulate our honorable award recipients.
Thank you very much. You may return to your seats. Professor Dame Gilbert, please come forward to the podium for your acceptance speech.
Thank you very much. On behalf of myself and my co-awardee, Professor Sir Andrew Pollard, I'm extremely honoured to receive this award today. It's particularly gratifying to us to receive an award from an institution that specialises in vaccines, vaccine development, vaccine production. So I'm very happy to be here. We must recognise that the work done on developing this vaccine, known as the Oxford-AstraZeneca vaccine against COVID-19, required a very large team effort. It required many years of preparation. We didn't know that we were preparing for this pandemic, but we knew that we were developing a technology that could be very flexible, very easily adaptable, and we always hoped to use it to save lives and to protect public health. As it turned out, we got our chance in 2020 to develop a vaccine, and we knew we needed to move very quickly because the disease was moving much more quickly than we ever could. So together with my colleagues, we worked on the initial creation of the vaccine in the research laboratories, the first manufacturing for clinical trials. We collaborated with people in the USA and National Institutes of Health to do the first safety testing in animals and demonstrate that it would be safe to be vaccinated with this vaccine and then to be exposed to the COVID-19 virus. We initiated clinical trials. For the first time ever, our country was in lockdown and we had to start clinical development of a vaccine when everything else was shut down. We had to work out new ways to doing this, but without losing momentum and maintaining the speed of vaccine development. That required a great deal of work from a large team who all worked together, putting this as their top priority at a very difficult time. We then were very fortunate to form a partnership with AstraZeneca, who worked hard to receive the technology from us at the university to make it available as widely as possible by working with many different manufacturing partners. And they worked with a large manufacturing network of whom, of course, SK Bioscience is a very important partner. And the aim was to have as many doses of the vaccine manufactured as possible so that we could make this vaccine available very widely. And it was eventually produced in more than 3 billion doses, used in 180 different countries, and was estimated by last year to have saved around 6 million lives. So we're very grateful for all of those who worked with us in the clinical trial sites in Brazil, South Africa, and also in Kenya, where we did clinical trials. And particularly grateful to all those who volunteered to come forward and take part in those clinical trials, because without our ability to vaccinate people with a novel vaccine and test its safety, immunogenicity, and efficacy for the first time, we wouldn't have been able to get this vaccine licensed and made available for use. So I think it's important that as academics, we continue to try to develop vaccines, but also continue in our role of education. It's important that we can explain to the public what it is that we're doing and why it's so important. And we don't hide from them the pros and cons of our vaccine technology, that we're as open as we possibly can be, because we now have to counter the problem of people being afraid to take vaccines in some circumstances. And I think as academics, both at the University of Oxford and the International Vaccine Institute, we have a role to play in boosting people's confidence by providing accurate and clear information about the vaccines that we're developing. So I'm very grateful to receive this award today from IVI and SK Bioscience. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Professor Dame Sarah Gilbert. Yes. We won't let you go empty-handed. Here are your flowers once again. Thank you very much. Now it's time to hear from Professor Andrew Pollard, who sent us a pre-recorded acceptance speech. Let's take a look.
I'm really delighted and humbled and honoured to receive the IVI SK Bioscience Park Van Hoon Award from the amazing team at IVI and SK Bioscience. And I'm particularly grateful to the IVI Award Selection Committee, chaired by Dr. Christian Mandel, Dr. Jerome King, Director General of IVI, and Dr. Hoon Kim, President of SK Bioscience, for making this award. It's obviously a great honor for me personally, but this award really is for all of the amazing scientists and researchers here in Oxford and around the world who are involved in the development of the Oxford AstraZeneca vaccine. Overall, there are about 2,000 people in the development team. Perhaps even more so is for those members of the public who took part in the clinical development of the Oxford AstraZeneca vaccine. There were 25,000 people who took part in that effort. And I think when you look at the public contribution to the development of vaccines, which really saved us in the pandemic, it's the greatest collective scientific endeavor of our generation. So I'm personally very humbled and honored to receive the award, but I do so on behalf of all of those scientists and the public who are absolutely critical to the development of interventions that improve human health. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Professor Pollard, for your acceptance speech. We do hope to see you in person very soon. That concludes the delivery of the award. Now we have a very special music performance. Violinist Ms. Lee Sang-hee in the beautiful yellow burlesque dress. She also serves as IVI's giving ambassador. And pianist Ms. Park Hee-won will together present a music performance to congratulate the awardees. Please welcome the duo with a big round of applause.
Thank you.
performance. Everyone, please give Ms. Lee and Ms. Park another big round of applause. Thank you very much. And with that, we will conclude the 2023 IVI SK Bioscience Park Man-hoon Award. Now to our four award recipients, on behalf of not just the International Vaccine Institute, or SK Bioscience, but on behalf of humankind, I would like to express our sincerest gratitude from the bottom of my heart for all your efforts, sacrifices, and contributions in the discovery, development, and delivery of vaccines so that everyone around the world can enjoy healthy lives. Once again, thank you very, very much. Please give our award recipients a big round of applause.